isn't always gray. It has a black stripe down the back. This little girl is a medium. That means that she's not pure black on top, but she's not pure gray either. She's just kind of average in the middle. And she's older, so this fur that's coming out is called priming. The difference between a gray and any other color is if you look at the tail, it's going to be black inside. I mean, that's true black. You look at that next here, she's black. Also, grays have this lovely white belly. So you look at her next to this paper, and she's black and gray. Your next most common color, and the one that is probably the most confused, is your hetero beige. And hetero just means that they got one copy of the beige gene, and they are brown. Now, if you look at this little girl next to this piece of paper, and you look at her tail, you'll see it is indeed brown. And anyway, you'll see that there's no black at all on this chinchilla. She's just brown, and she has pink eyes and pink ears. The biggest differentiator between sapphires and beiges is the pink ears and pink eyes. The next most common color I see people get confused by is sapphire. And sapphire, like your beige, they have no black on them. There's no black in the tail, but they have dark ears. They also have very dark eyes, as you can see on this girl. She's a little darker on the back. But if you look at her on this piece of paper, she's blue. There's no brown on this chinchilla. And I don't know where my beige ran off to, but I'll show you them next to each other. So this is a beige, a nice blue beige. This is a sapphire. See, this one has pink ears, pink eyes. This one has gray ears. The next color I'm going to show you is violet. Now, violets I am starting to see more of in pet stores, but they're easy to tell because if you look at their tail, it's a very solid dark color. And their back is very solid. That's a violet. If we compare the violet to the beige, you can see one is brown, one is kind of a dove gray color. And this is what they look like. That's paper. They also have dark gray ears. Your chin is a beige or some sort of tan if it has pink ears and pink eyes. Go violet, go see. Now the color you're least likely to see, and I have people say, hey, I think I bought a blue diamond at the pet store. You did not. This is a blue diamond. Like a violet, they have a solid tail, but they're a lot lighter color. So if you look at the sapphire next to the blue diamond, you'll see she has a very smooth, even coat. And sapphires always have a bit of a patchy white under fur. If you blow into them, you can see the white. Alright, so next is blue diamond versus violet. Violet and blue diamond are actually very close. That's probably because these girls are related. Violet's going to be a darker, richer gray color. Blue diamond, you're going to see, has lighter ears. They both have dark brown eyes. You just got to know your lines. The violet's always going to have a much darker tail. I mean, that's almost black. This is almost blue, if you look at it compared to the paper. So again, the difference in the colors between all your recessives and your gray is your gray has black. Black tail, black fur. Not all grays have black fur, but they do all have black tail. So this is gray, blue diamond, sapphire, violet, beige. And this is the only animal in this group of colors that has pink ears.